This right here, this is awesome news. And when people say, oh, you can't trust SafeMoon because it has the word safe in its name, it's obviously a scam, it's obviously a rug pull, I'm sorry, but those people are just ignorant. They're jumping to conclusions. They haven't actually done adequate research into anything. And the release of the wallet, and specifically this information we're about to share, is one of those defining moments where it helps clarify the name SafeMoon and reinforces the idea that it is more safe. So check this out. SafeMoon wallet is number one for privacy. This is some research that was conducted and posted on the SafeMoon subreddit, posted by Daily Leaked. This is about 8 hours ago, but it really deserves more upvotes in my opinion, because again, this is something that's very, very important. So if we take a look here for the privacy, this person decided to do some investigative research into a series of other cryptocurrency wallets. Excuse me. And it says, it says right here, SafeMoon is the only app that doesn't collect data. Data collection. The purpose of the label is to help your customers understand what data is collected from your app and how it is used. To complete that, you'll need to know the types of data that you and or your third-party partners collect from your app before answering the questions in App Store Connect. Keep in mind that even if you collect the data for reasons other than analytics or advertising, it still needs to be declared. For example, if you collect data solely for the purpose of app functionality, declare the data on your label and indicate that it is only being used for that purpose. Collect refers to transmitting data off the device in a way that allows you and or your third-party partners to access it for a period longer than what is necessary to service the transmitted requests in real time. Third-party partners refers to analytics tools, advertising networks, third-party SDKs, or other external vendors whose code you've added to your app. Decided to compare SafeMoon to some other top crypto wallets and noticed that SafeMoon was the only one that didn't collect data. Data ranking. Number one, SafeMoon. Number two, Binance. Number three, Trust Wallet. Number four, MetaMask. Number five, Coinbase. Number six, Crypto.com. What do you think about this comparison? I think it's absolutely amazing. Let's go ahead and blow up this image so we can see it a little bit better. By the way, I do want to say, while this is loading, again, I'm not a financial advisor. Everything I'm sharing is my own opinions, my own research. I encourage you guys to go do your own research as usual. So let's go and take a look at this. Zooming on in here. Data not collected. Information. This is seller. SafeMoon US LLC. And then if we go ahead and pan on over here, data used to track you. Who is this one from? This one is through, where did it go? So we got SafeMoon LLC, which is the one on the right. This one here is, it doesn't seem like it's saying it on the spot. Okay, then we go ahead and look over at this one right here. Same thing, data linked to you. We've got data linked to you, data not linked to you, data not linked to you. So there's some that collect data that is used to track you, some that is not linked to you, but they're still collecting data. And it shows what some of these things are, like browsing history, identifiers, usage data, diagnostics. And guess what? With the SafeMoon one, data not collected. We can reaffirm this. I just got a sample for you guys. So if you go to the App Store, you can look at SafeMoon right here. I'm on the computer. I just scroll on down. It says app privacy. It says data not collected. The developer does not collect any data from this app. Any data. Now let's go look at Trust Wallet. If we go to Trust Wallet and we scroll on down, app privacy. Developer 6 days indicates the app privacy's practices may include handling of data as described below. Data not linked to you. The following data may be collected, but it is not linked, but is not linked to your identity. Browsing history, usage data, identifiers, and diagnostics. So they are still pulling some form of data from you. So if you wanted to have the most safe wallet from the information that we're being provided, I mean, how much more safe can you get than them not collecting any data at all, right? Plus, you have the levels of encryption that's being developed, reinforced, the two-factor authentication, all that kind of stuff. It reinforces the idea of SafeMoon being considered safe, at least for the wallet perspective side. Then you look at what's coming out with SafeMoon version 2, and that is supposed to have a higher level of security as stated by the SafeMoon CEO as well. And that's right around the corner, guys. You look at the security audit from Certic, right? And that shows it's doing very well on top of everything else. It has been audited by a highly accredited auditor. And that's old. That's months old, right? But yeah, we're moving forward. We're making progress. Registered LLC company out of the United States. This isn't a Chinese-based company. Some people in the United States are very, very concerned about doing anything with apps or companies that are based out of China. Well, guess what? If you're one of those kinds of people, you don't even have to worry about it, right? So this is absolutely awesome news moving forward. Let us know in the comments what you guys think about this. I am planning on going live tonight at 5 p.m. Pacific Standard Time on this channel. That is West Coast Los Angeles time. And so if you guys want to come and hang out with me, I would love to have you guys be there. And also, if you guys have not already, be sure to check out the links in the description. You got free cryptocurrency or free stock. It's free money for you guys. And if you're new to the channel, don't forget to hit subscribe. Hit the thumbs up like button. It does help us out with the YouTube search algorithm. Click that little bell icon so you know whenever we got a new video or we go live. And I will see you guys in the next episode.